Now, let's come to unit test, right? So, as I told you, there are three, scenarios given to us. So these three scenarios are case one, case two, case three. I already discussed these three scenarios in the problem statement. So if you have not watched problem statement, so I think it's a good time to watch the problem statement first so that you can understand all the three scenarios. But while explaining the test cases, I'll be explaining the bit on the scenarios also. So let me show you all the test case. So I've created one test case for each of the scenario so that I can, show you that they are all working fine. So the test case one says that user does not get temporarily unavailable seats, right? So you, if you, if you, if I just tell you, so user U1 and U2 were there. U1 select the seats, and U2 should not get those seats back, right? So that's what we have done here. And there is some base class which I have used for, creating some controllers, creating services, and there are some common methods which I have created in the common base class. I'll be discussing those when I reach that point. So let me just start telling you the test cases. So case one says that user one selects some seats and users two should not see them because they are sort of temporarily locked. So you create a movie, you set up screen, you create some seats in the screen, you create some show. These are all arrangement or setup thing. Then you get all the available seats. So user one get the available seats first in the beginning. And what we are validating that we are validating that user one should get all the seats which the screen has, because there is no neither booking has been done nor lock has been done. So that's what we are validating here. So this validate method is a helper method which we have created. It takes three things. One is the seat list, which has to be validated, then all the seats which should be there in the seat list, and all the seats which should not be there in the seat list, right? So that's what we are checking here. So so we are just validating whether the included seat should be there, and then we are checking the excluded seat should not be there. And while included seat, we are checking like this should not be in the excluded seat, because here we are returning all the seats, not all the seats in the screen. So I think I should just rename this method, all seats in screen. That makes more sense. So all seat list we are validating like all the seats that should be there, but except the excluded seats. So we are checking the all the seats which should be there except the excluded seat are there, and all the seats which should not be there are not there, right? So these are the two checks which this method is doing, and we are using it here. So we are validating U1 should receive all the screen one seats, and there should not be any seat which should be excluded, right? So that's what we are checking. And then we say U1 select some seats. So user one select 0 to 5 10, let's say U1 selected some seats and U1 started created the booking. And let's say user one finish the payment, and payment becomes successful. So this one test case is actually for permanent available and not temporarily available. I think I have to rename the methods, the test methods. But case one, if you read in the statement, U1 actually payment U1 actually come proceeds with the payment before U2 request for the seats. So we user one create the booking and user one completes the payment. Then U2 gets the available seats for the show, and we are validating that that seats that U2 got are the all the screen seats except the ones which are already booked by U1, right? That's what we have to validate. So that's what we are validating here. We are validating U2 get all the U2 available seats have all the screen one seats except the seats which are already selected by U1. Now let's see case two. And case two here says, U1 and U2 select the same show, and U1 select some group of seats. U1 proceeds to pay. U2 also get all the seats. Then U2 do not see the seats selected by U1. Then U1 payment fails, then U2 should see the seats back, right? Because the payment for U1 has failed. So let's see the case two. So case two, again, we do some setup. Now U1 select some seat. I mean, again, U1 first get all the seats, and we are validating U2. U1 gets all the seats which are there in the screen. Then U1 select some screen, sorry, seats. U1 starts booking for the seats. Sorry, yeah, U1 starts booking for the seat. When U2 select the seats, or U2 actually get all the available seats, then U2 gets seats which are there in the screen, but except the seats which are selected by U1. Now payment failed for U1, right? Then we again get the seats for U2, after the payment failed, and we again validate that the seats that you two receive after the payment failure is all the screen seats, and there should not be any excluded seat because you and payment failed now, right? Earlier, until the payment failed, the seats were blocked and they were not returned in the available seats, and that's what we validated earlier. But now the seats should not be there in the return output. Now we have case three. Case three says that we have let's see the problem statement first. So case three says that you and you two select the same show. You and you two get all the seats available for the show. You and select with the proceeds. You and proceed with the payment. And you two select the overlapping seats. And now you two should get the exception that these seats are not available. So let's see. Again, we do some setup part. You and get all the available seats. In the U1 available seat, we get all the seats. There should not be any excluded seats. Now U1 and U2, both start to book some seats, right? So U1 and U2 both select some seats. First of all, U1 starts booking. U1 creates a booking or U1 locks the seat. Then let's say U2 also tries to lock the same seats, right? We have a common seat, which is a seat number 0 and seat number 2. Right, seat number 1 and 3 are different, but seat number 2 and 0 are same. So there are some overlapping seats between U1 and U2. So U1 first of all lock the seats, then U2 also tries to lock the same seats. So U2 gets exception that these seats are temporarily unavailable. Now U2 proceeds with the payment, and the payment becomes successful. So now when U2 again tries to book the seats or start book the seat, then U2 gets this exception as seat permanently available because now the payment has been completed. Now, to validate that everything is correct, and I am not just writing, I have not written this just to tell you, the code is also working correct. Let me just try to run the code in front of you, and all the test case I guess should pass now. So this is building, and tests are running, and all the tests have passed. So you can see test pass. So that's how the code is running fine, and all the three cases that we have in the problem statement are working fine.